Oh, damn, my fault, y'all. I'm here. It's your boy, Insanity. What's good, everybody? I'm sorry about that, yo. I was just checking to make sure nobody was in this room with me while I do this commentary. Because I swear, like, this is probably my sixth or eighth time trying to finish this commentary for you guys. I don't know what's going on. I get, like, halfway through the video, and then I don't know if I'm blacking out or what's going on, but, get halfway through, and the next thing you know, I'm already at the end of the video, so I'm just not sure what's going on. It's kind of crazy, kind of freaking me out, but, you know, I did some P90X, got me some coffee, I'm on my 5-hour energy, so I'm ready to go, man. I should be good to go. So, you know, I got my spaz out, trying to catch people off guard that really ain't thinking about what they're doing, like this guy. What are you placing a claymore there for, sir? I helped him out. So, I got my spaz out, you know what I'm saying? People don't expect you to have a shotgun on this map. So, I just said I want to try something different on this map and just pull out a shotty. Can't really get into too many gunfights, but if you take the right route, you can catch people off guard. Like this guy, I don't know what he was doing. He was running with his head down, looking for coins or whatever. So, that's basically it. You can't really try to get into a gunfight with these guys because, you know, everybody has assault rifles, so you're going to lose that battle every time. So you got to pick your routes carefully. Keep it moving. You got to keep running. And you should be good to go as long as you're picking the right routes, you know where they're spawning, where they're spawning in at what point in time, and you should be all set. So, right here, ooh, I don't know how he didn't kill me. But I'm on a nice little streak, got my Blackbird. And I would recommend putting on Marathon Pro, must have. I don't think I have it on this one, but I would recommend it because it gets annoying when you're trying to, you know, maneuver and get to those spots. It helps you out a lot. Oh no, I'm sorry about you. This guy's keep looking over my shoulder, man. I swear somebody is in this room with me, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just tripping, yo. I'm gonna definitely get through this commentary this time, no doubt. But I don't know why I feel so tired, man. I had a good nap. I don't know, man. I feel like I'm fading out on you guys. I don't know what's going on, man. There's no way I'm doing this commentary over again. I'm good. I should be good, but I just got this feeling that it's gonna happen again.
Go to sleep and good night. I better put you in sleeper out again. And he's out. Man, that was quicker this time. Hola, my friends. It is I, living wrestling legend and Call of Duty noob, Alberto. Gamertag is I am Alberto, hanging out here. Well, he doesn't know it, with good friend Insanity and Saint Demeanor in his casa. And man, he's got no idea. I've been in his house for like 2 weeks. He has no idea. You can tell Alberto wearing a ghillie suit I bought off an Army Navy surplus store. I decide for Halloween, Alberto going to be a bullshit corner camper wearing ghost, eating downloadable s'mores from Treyarch. And he has no idea I'm here. And I pass him out, look around his house here. I can do that. I am living legend. Would the cops show up? Oh, who is that in his house? Oh, my God, it is Alberto. Here, sign autographs for my baby and all this bullshit. So they would not care. I am Alberto. But, yeah, I've found a lot here, man. I don't know if he ever showed you video of his casa here. Oh, my God, he is completely crazy. I find pornography on his hard drive here, download it to a Alberto iPad. He hid it on his desktop on a folder that said Oregon Trail. I was like, oh my God, I love Oregon Trail. No one will ever, you know, I will never die of cholera. And you always hire an Indian, or sorry, my bad, Native American to forge the river. I mean, everyone knows that, no bullshit. So I'm like, I'm going to play this. And it was tons of pornography. So why not? They downloaded it onto a Alberto iPad. And Insanity, man. He's crazy, completely loco. I mean, he's got crazy stuff here. Like, he's got women wearing Big Bird outfits, dressed up like Snuffleupagus, you know, hitting on dudes with bicycle chains. He's even got a video of David Vanderhaar's mother, unspreading her legs. It sound like Velcro. So, man, whatever gets him off, whatever. But he's completely crazy. This is true, too. I know this for a fact. Because, you know, we are friends, and one time we get real drunk at Ruby Tuesday, and, you know, he tell me embarrassing story. David Vanderhaar was like, oh my God, Insanity, you are a god at this bullshit. Gamer Mac, hey, if you sleep with my mother, and you know, if you can get over her legs sounding like Velcro when they uncross, I will fix the hit detection in my bullshit game. And he lied. He lied to Insanity. So Insanity, pick him up and power drive David Van Die Hart into complete bullshit. And never text or call his mother back, but he can still hear the echoes of his mother's vajayjay uncrossing sounding like Velcro. That will haunt a man forever. You know, complete bullshit. So what does he do? He takes it out on these bullshit corner campers wearing ghosts in this game. And, you know, like I say, he's very, very good friend. I've been telling him for a while, listen, Insanity, you need to run for political office in 2012. He said, no, I cannot do this, Alberto. But listen, if Michelle Bachmann can run, and that crazy-eyed psycho bitch is, I mean, she's crazy. I see advertisement today, it's like, vote for Michelle Bachmann. She wants to take your children, douse them in a white wine sauce, cook them for dinner, and feed them to Snooki. No bull. If she can run, he can run. Look at all the gold guns. Every time a Buddha play with Insanity and Saint Demeanor, he's got a different golden gun. He could go onto Pawn Stars and see Chumley, and Chumley be like, oh my god, and Saint Demeanor, I love seeing you because every time you're here, I get a better contact high than when I went to a Snoop Dogg Cypress Hill concert back in the late, you know, 90s, some bull. So, you know, he could pawn his golden guns, and with that money alone, because he's got like a billion million of them, he'd get so much money, he could pay off the national debt. Anyway, you know what the Birdo does now? I need to pause for these quick Birdo-like messages.
Brought to you by Jell-O Pudding. Nothing gets the bitches and hoes like a yummy cup of Jell-O Pudding.
Then he kill another corner camper wearing ghost, complete bull. Jump off the top turnbuckle, now he's got Blackbird, game is completely over. Runs to the other side of Steel Cage, jumps up and powderizes everyone on the map into complete a bull. This is what this man does. When he's not passed out on the floor because the Birdo puts him in sleeper hold for like 4 times this week. Look, he looks like a little baby. He's passed out. Drool going down his chin. Probably smell like tequila, Jose Cuervo, or maybe, you know, David Vanderhaar's mother's crotch that sounds like Velcro when she spreads it. I hope he's not dreaming of that. This man is a legend. He deserved better. No bullshit. Should be dreaming of bitches and hoes filleting him and feeding him expensive ham because he is living legend who power drive everyone into complete bullshit. Now he's got dogs. Look at this. This is crazy. It is like he is on a different level. Infinity Ward should put him on the next game on like a 20-second delay just to make it more fair for everyone. Plus, it gives him a challenge. Because look, he cannot be challenged by this. If we lose Insane Demeanor because game is too easy, it will be a serious loss to the Call of Duty community. It will be like when Alberto retired from wrestling. Horrible day in the history of man. Look, he's like in Michael Bay movie. Look, explosions, and they're like climbing scaffolding, trying to get away from him. Complete bull. Get on his level. They are like in Sisterhood of the Traveling Bullshit Joy Luck Pants, and he is like in Michael Bay movie. But man, he is so cool. Look at this. For real here. He's like out worse. Remember classic match with Alberto versus Bushwhackers in Steel Cage? You get one Bushwhacker in one arm, one Bushwhacker in the other arm, and I knocked them out simultaneously using my legendary Akimbo dual-wielding sleeper hold move. He's out worse than that. Ooh, and that match will be in the next Best of Alberto WWE DVD if David Vanderhaar doesn't steal that idea from Alberto too. Now he's in Chopper Gunner, so you know what Alberto do. Put in my iPod and listen to a song, drink Corona, check in my voicemail, and Alberto be right back. Trying to get crazy with this, don't you know, loco? Alright, Taburo's back, living wrestling legend and video game noob here. I'm telling you, insanity, loco, crazy. Sometimes he takes his bitches, hoes, shorties out to Red Lobster. He does not even eat the cheddar biscuits. That is crazy. Listen, when the apocalypse actually happens and volcanoes explode and David Vandahar's mother flies out of one uncrossing her legs to consume us all with the sound of Velcro, even Jesus Christo eat the cheddar biscuits. They are glorious. Anyway, we've got to go. He's going to be waking up soon. Do not forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. Subscribe and gamer tag is I am Buru.
Are you serious? It happened again? God damn it, man. Now I gotta do it again? I'm getting sick of this shit.